The Continental GT appeared, with its huge pace and majestic looks, and its rise continues today with a facelift second generation. The four-door flying spur and drop-top GTC were introduced in 2005 and have been subsequently replaced too. In 2009, the limited edition 621 BHP Supersports showed that Bentley was still capable of producing something resembling the most unlikely superfast bruisers it was famous for. Some will find it comforting to think of Bentley's implied heavyweight sporting elegance as an intransigent part of Britain's automotive landscape, as evocative as the thwack of willow on leather, the smell of a village pub, or the peal of a church bell. But, in truth, the company is no more resistant to the preoccupations of the 21st century than any other cultural benchmark. And so, like limited overs cricket or gastro pubs, Bentley has moved with the times and, with the considerable help of its German-Czech writer, Volkswagen, introduced the green and pleasant version of the Continental GTC that it promised in 2008. Of course, some things don't change. The continued fitment of the 6.0-liter W12 engine is proof of that. Bentley may have delivered the 40% improvement Indiana economy and emissions that it said it would, but that hefty reduction still permitted the fitment of a twin-turbocharged 4.0-liter V8 petrol engine from Audi that produces 500 bhp. The question is, are those 500 four-ringed geldings capable of mimicking Bentley Shire horses aboard the mobile amphitheater that is the GTC?